Will my backup work if I replace my motherboard? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. I would like to upgrade my motherboard to the latest processor. I did a full backup of my C drive. Would it reinstall with all my current programs to the new system? The best I can say is maybe. In fact, I'll even go so far as to say probably. But I'll also point out that you may not necessarily need the backup at all. Good that you have it, you might need it, but you might not need it for the scenario that you're just talking about. When you're replacing the motherboard, you're essentially changing the foundation of your computer, the fundamental nature of your computer, the CPU, a lot of the circuitry that goes along with it, some of the built-in circuits like audio, video now are built into motherboards and such. So what's happening is that there's a lot of stuff that's changing. Now, the image of your system that is either on your backup or, for that matter, just on the hard drive that I'm presuming you did not change, it's configured for a different motherboard. It has drivers for that hardware, that audio device, that CPU, that circuitry. When you replace the motherboard and you suddenly reboot and bring up Windows using that motherboard, Windows then goes through kind of a culture shock, if you will. It says, oh crap, everything's changed, or all this stuff has changed. It will try really, really hard to accommodate all of the changes. Windows, especially in more recent versions, has become actually fairly resilient to change. So there's a very good chance that it'll say, oh, it's this audio device now and not that audio device, and this, you know, CPU and not that CPU, those kinds of things. It'll make a lot of those changes transparently under the hood. And the chances are it'll probably work. I keep saying probably because honestly, it really depends on just how different your motherboard is from the original. The more different it is, the higher the likelihood of things not working or at least not being stable after the fact. So my recommendation is that you do this. You don't need your backup. You go ahead and replace your motherboard, plug in the hard drive, reboot the machine, and see what happens. If it doesn't boot, well, then you know that something has to happen. If it does boot, my recommendation is that you use it for a while. You exercise the programs you have installed. You exercise the hardware that's attached. And I say that because that exercise is hopefully going to expose any other issues that may have cropped up from changing the motherboard. It's possible that something could be detected and repaired on the spot by Windows, or it could be one of those things where Windows suddenly says, hey, something changed, I can't deal with it, help. The bottom line is that playing with it is really the only way you'll get a good answer. Now, you've got a backup to begin with. That's fantastic. If you didn't have a backup before replacing your motherboard, take a backup image, a full image of the hard disk before you replace the motherboard. That's a safety net. If things go wrong, if things go horribly wrong, you'll be able to use that for a couple of different reasons. Now, of course, if your hard disk won't boot because Windows is so different and your backup has an image of the hard disk, the backup isn't going to boot either, right? You could restore the backup all you want, but you're just restoring what was already on the hard disk that you know didn't work. The backup becomes useful in a couple of other scenarios. If the new motherboard causes your system to not work, not boot, not work properly, whatever, then you've got a couple of different approaches to take. One is to repair Windows. You can do that from Windows installation media, which you can download. And hopefully that will basically run Windows through most of its setup process that will cause it to redetect all of the hardware on your system and reconfigure itself for all of the changes. That actually is probably a pretty good solution. It'll probably work. The problem, of course, is that depending on the choices you make during that process, you may lose all of your installed programs and your data. It'll be kind of sort of like installing Windows from scratch. In that case, you'll need to reinstall your software and recover your data, presumably from the backup that you took. The other approach, the worst case approach, the if all else fails approach, is in fact to reinstall Windows from scratch. If things are so badly broken that you can't do a repair, that you can't just boot the thing and work, the thing to do then is to do a complete fresh reinstall of Windows, and that by definition, A, should configure itself for your new hardware, but then also will require that you reinstall your applications, recover your data from your backup or wherever else is convenient, and then you should be able to move on. But in all honesty, these days, giving it a try is the first step that I would take, because I think there's a very high likelihood that it'll probably just work. For updates, for comments, and for related links, visit askleo.com/147219. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.